Members of Parliament representing workers including Arinaitwe Rwakajara, Agnes Kunihira, Margaret Rabushaija and Abdul Biakatonda were the first to appear before the House's Select Committee investigating corruption in the National Social Security Fund. They asked the committee to pique interest in finding how the 100 billion shillings collected monthly by NSSF is invested.
Dealing now here with cash, as they said, every month 100 billion enter NSSF account. I mean, it's every day there is money that pops on the NSSF account. What does the law say? These people are supposed to be investing all the money that pops on their account. Because a day that misses investing that money, it is a loss on the saver's money. So, how do we know now how long does it take to invest this money?
Other issue at the fund that always causes problems is the issue of investment in real estate. When you look at all other investments, there are never wars, never fights. But you also know when it comes to real estate, that's why there is physical exchange of monies, building, construction, buying land. So we always get issues. We always get issues. Even during our time there when we were on the board, we had issues of Lwowa. We found when the issue of Temangalo was also winding up. So those issues will always come. I think now you must investigate into the small percentage of the real estate where there are problems. Other investments rarely have problems.
Workers MP cited instances where the management of the fund deliberately delays investments, thus affecting savers' interest earnings. In this regard, MPs urged the ad hoc committee to recommend a forensic audit into the operations of NSSF and done by an international body which can withstand the temptation of bribery by the fund managers.
Need an international organization that can audit, that has a serious reputation, that cannot be compromised, or else we are just on the show.
They also cautioned the committee to observe the scandal keenly, as it may be an opportunity manipulated by the Minister of Finance in order to use it as a ground to take back sole supervision of the fund, which is currently under dual supervision of the Minister of Gender and Finance.
It's not because the fund is in gender that we are having problems, but we need to handle these issues administratively, and I think you should seek for mechanisms of addressing these pending challenges.
Yes, in NSSF. Maybe now that you're in this committee, you may start seeing some pop up on there. But some people underground, every day they are thinking about NSSF and they sleep in NSSF. So they will not release anybody whom they have started working with. But if you are not working with them, they will make sure you leave that position.
The committee also interfaced with officials of NSSF board led chairman Peter Chimbawa together with other board members and grilled them over the alleged 6 billion shillings which the gender minister Betty Amongi requested for from the savers fund.
You are now getting requests from a minister who is supposed to be more like an admin. And you have gone further to even discuss this 6 billion.
Yes.
Not considering the irregularities involved in the request. So now the question was simple. Was this request, did it come to the board? Did you find it irregular or not?
It wasn't right for the minister to even engage with the management directly. That wasn't necessary. But as to the fact that the board owns it, that's not possible for us to say the board owns something we haven't seen. In terms of looking at the work plan and going through it with management, we have it. The committee hasn't passed it yet.
The committee chairperson, Mwini Mpaka, grilled the officials whether they had approved the 6 billion shillings request by the minister and whether it was irregular or not.
If you think there's an irregularity, I don't know why you keep owning it, because it is also going to impact on you in the recommendations we are going to make. But I see you are all covering up, and we really...
Your budget to the minister for approval. The minister approved the budget, but that approval came with a letter which you are calling the idea. the chair is asking, was that use, was it regular? Is it legal? Is it procedurally proper that the idea comes that way, direct to the board?
What the minister did, irregular or not, it is irregular. That's number one. Number two, you have said the letter is addressed to the chair. When the letter comes to the chair, I know it is not supposed to. So what we did was to push it in the normal system. That yes, we have seen, we have observed, we have noted this, but can it go through the normal system of proposal, receipt, analysis, and then presentation to the committee, then the committee brings it to the board. That hasn't happened.
It is alleged that Minister Amongi declined to reappoint the former NSSF Managing Director, Richard Biarugaba, after the fund failed to approve the 6 billion shillings request. Hassan Rabai Mudiba, the National Organization of Trade Unions representative on the NSSF board, said that it was irregular for the minister to initiate the budget request. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.